Hello everyone, welcome to the video lecture on chain codes. In previous session we have seen how we can find out the 4 chain codes and 8 chain codes. Now there we have seen that to find out the chain codes we have to first of all select one starting point. But what will happen if we change the starting point of the chain code? What do we get? Here is the example which we have seen in our previous session, and the chain code obtained for this example when we select the starting point P as this. When we selected this pixel as our starting point, in that case we will get the chain code like this. But if we are now going to change our starting point P, then what will happen to this we will see. Now let's consider this as our starting point. So this pixel is our starting point. In this case what will be our chain code? So we'll move from this pixel to this pixel, from this to this, likewise. So according with this our chain code will get is from this pixel to this pixel chain code will be 1, okay. From this pixel to this pixel it will be 1 to 2. From this to this again 1. From this to this 0. Here we'll have 7. From this to this we'll have 5. From this pixel to this pixel we'll have 7. This pixel to this pixel we'll have 5. From this pixel to this pixel we'll have code 4. From this pixel to this pixel code 4. And from this pixel to the starting pixel we'll have code 3. So if we compare the chain code for 2 different starting points, that chain code will be changing. Chain code, this is 8 chain code. So chain code, 8 chain code for this starting pixel will be this, while for this starting pixel will be this. Okay, and it will be totally different codes will obtain if we select the different starting point. And this is the problem which we are going to face in this chain codes if we are going to change the starting point of the chain code. Here the contour is same, still due to the selection of starting point the chain code will be different. So what we can do in this case? So in this case what we can do is nothing but we can normalize the chain code with respect to the starting point by a method in which we can find out the first difference, shape number and order of chain code, and we can normalize this chain code. Now let's see how we can do that. So let's consider this is the 8 chain code, and let's consider this as an example for our chain code. So given 8 chain code, that given 8 chain code will consider the same 0, 7, 5, 7, 5, 4, 4, 3, 1, 2, 1. Okay. Here, first of all, we'll find out the first difference, then we'll find out the shape number, and after that, we'll find out the order for the chain code. Now, how we can find out the first difference? So, this first difference is calculated by taking the two numbers at a time. And then we have to count the number of positions required to reach from the first number to the second number. Okay. And for this we have to consider the counterclockwise direction. Means we have to move in this direction. We have to consider the counterclockwise direction like this. Okay. So here I'll write down the chain code once again for convenience. 0, 7, 5, 7, 5, 4, 4, 3, 1, 2, 1. So as we have seen, first we'll consider these two numbers, okay, 0 and 7. So first is 0 number and second is 7 number. Now we'll move from number 0 to number 7, and along this move we have to consider the number of positions required to reach the 7 number, okay, and we have to move in this counterclockwise direction. So this is first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth and seventh. So here the first difference between 0 and 7 is 7, between 7 and 5. So this is 7, first number, second number is 5. So we'll move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So this difference is 6. After this, between 5 and 7. So 5 and 7, 1 and 2. We have to move from first number to second number. This is first number, this is second number. In this case, in third case, first number is 7, second number is 5. So from 7 to 5, positions are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Between 5 and 4, 5 and 4 will move in counterclockwise direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Between 4 and 4, we have to move 0 time. So this difference will be 0. Between 4 and 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Between 3 and 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Between 1 and 2, there is 1. And between 2 and 1, there are 7. So the first difference for the given 8 chain code is 7626707617. This is the first difference. Now we'll find circular first difference. For that circular first difference, what we have to do? We have to find out the number of positions required to move from last number to the first number in the first difference case, and we have to keep we have to write this code as it is, like this: 7626707617. This is our first difference, so we'll write down this first difference as it is, like this. Okay, and then we'll find out the difference or number of positions required from last number to the first number. Okay, so that number of positions required from last number is 7 and the first number is 7, so it will be 0. So this is our circular first difference. Let's take another example. Let's consider the chain code provided is 10103322. Okay, so what will be the first difference? So here if you observe, this is 4 chain code. So for that 4 chain code, we'll find out the first difference between 1 and 0. Here I'll write down 0, 1, 2 and 3. So between 1 and 0, there is 1, 2 and 3. Okay. Then between 0 and 1, there is 1. Between 1 and 0, there will be 3. Between 0 and 3, there will be 1, 2 and 3. Between 3 and 3, there will be 0. And between 3 and 2, 1, 2 and 3. And between 2 and 2, there will be 0. Okay. So this is the first difference. Now the circular first difference. What will be the circular first difference? For that, we have to write down this chain code as it is, like this: 3, 1, 3, 3, 0, 3, 0. And then we have to find out the number of positions required to move from last number to the first number. Last number is 0, first number is 3. So that 0 to 3 positions are 3, and that we have to write down at the starting of this first difference. And whatever code we are getting, this code is called as circular first difference. Now after this circular first difference, we can find out the shape number. So what is this shape number? The shape number of a boundary which is obtained from the chain code is defined as the smallest magnitude of the circular first difference. We have to find out the smallest magnitude of this circular first difference, and that we have to write down as a shape number. Okay, so if we observe this number, from this number we have to identify the smallest magnitude, and that smallest magnitude is 0303 33133. So this is nothing but the shape number for the provided chain code. Okay, after this we can also find out the order. That order of the shape number can be defined as the number of digits in the representation of shape number. So how many digits are there in shape number? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Okay, so here the number of digits are 9, so the order will be 9. Sorry, here I have made mistake. Here one mistake is there. I have written 3 twice. It is 0. Shape number will be the smallest magnitude, which is 030 030 331 331 33. Okay, so according with that, the number of digits in the given sequence are 8, so the order will be 8. So by this way we can find out chain code, first difference, circular first difference, and the shape number and order. We'll see one example based on this. So the example is, find the shape number and the order of the given boundary. Use 4 chain codes. This is the given boundary and this is 4 chain code representation. Now we have to find out the shape number. First of all, we'll find out 4 chain code for given sequence. Okay, so for this we'll select the starting point, this as a starting point. We'll move from this point to this point. The movement is this, so our code will be 0. From this to this, our code will be 3. From this to this, our code will be 0. From this to this, code will be 3. From this point to this point, code will be 2. Again from this point to this point, code will be 2. From this point to this point, code will be 1. And from this point up to starting point, our code will be 1. Okay, so this is our obtained chain code. The first difference, that first difference is between 0 and 3, which is 1, 2 and 3. Between 3 and 0, it is 1. Between 0 and 3, it is 3. Between 3 and 2, 3 and 2, so 1, 2 and 3. Between 2 and 2, it is 0. Between 2 and 1, it is 3. And between 1 and 1, it is 0. So the first difference is 3, 1, 3, 3, 0, 3, 0. Okay. After that, we'll find out the circular first difference. Okay, and for that circular first difference, we'll write down the first difference as it is 3, 1, 3, 3, 0, 3, 0, and then we'll find out the number of positions required to move from last number to first number. That means 0 to 3, the positions required are 3, and that we'll write down at the start of the first difference, and whatever code we'll get, that is the circular first difference. After that, we have to write down the shape number. That shape number is nothing but the smallest magnitude of the circular first difference, and that smallest magnitude is 0 30 33 133. So this is our shape number, and order for given boundary, that order is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. That is equal with the number of digits present in the shape number. So this is the chain code, first difference, circular first difference, shape number and order for given boundary.